There's one more style of notation I'd like to introduce. I won't use it that often in this course, but it's quite standard. It's likely you'll see it elsewhere, so I think that I should at least cover it briefly. Okay. So again, we have an iterated function, which is just a loop. We input x, apply f to it, get an output, and then we repeat. So x1, the first value in the itinerary, is just f applied to my seed or initial condition. To get x2, I apply f to x1. To get the next value in the orbit, the next value in the itinerary, I just apply the function to the current value. Here's another way to think about this. To get x2, I start with the seed and I do f to it twice. So I start with x0, do the function to it once, I get x1, twice I get x2. We can write that in a formula as follows. So this notation means x2, to get x2, I start with my seed x0, apply f to it, and apply f to it again. In other words, x2 is f applied twice to x0. Similarly, x3, the third iterate, I obtain by starting with the seed and applying f to it three times. I can write that as follows. So x3 is x0 after f acts on it again and again. So this is x0 to which f has been applied three times. Writing all these f's in a row is a little bit cumbersome, so there's a shorthand notation for this. So this, f with a 3 to the parentheses, is understood to mean f done three times. So this is x0 after f has acted on it three times. And in general, this notation, f with an n up in a superscript in parentheses, means f applied n times to x. It's doing f n times in a row to whatever the input was.